What's up, guys? Zappadat back once again, reporting for duty. And today, I got a special video. I just woke up to like 50 subs, which is completely awesome. I know it's not a lot compared to a lot of other people, but it's kind of like the first milestone of Zappadat, I would like to think. And recently, I've just been communicating with you guys. You guys have been showing me mad support. I've gotten new subscribers since I realized that there are shout-out videos out there and that I might possibly be eligible for a few of them, which is completely fucking awesome, you know? Finally, there's a group of YouTubers, you know, helping each other grow. I'm loving all the support everyone's showing one another, and, you know, it's just completely awesome. I'll talk more about certain shout-outs and everything in an update video that I might do after this video, which is my setup video! Finally, you guys get a setup video. Not that any of you have been asking for it in anything. I haven't seen a comment asking about my setup yet, but you know what? Oh well, I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm gonna do like a little before and after type thing, because the way my setup is now, it's absolutely fucking awful. Like, it's not awful in the sense that it's messy or anything, but it's awful in the sense that it's a lot of like older things and stuff that really isn't for gaming, but I don't know, it's just not what you'd expect in a, you know, normal setup video. It's a lot of older things. So first off, I like to get started with the puppies, with the dogs right here. That'd be Autumn right there, the red lab. Beautiful, beautiful color on her. You know, she's perfect fucking. I got my dog Amber right here. We don't know what the hell she is. We think she's like some sort of like Shiba Inu, blue healer mixed-ish type thing. And then we got this 12-year-old blind, dementia, diabetic ridden dog. She's fucking awesome. We've gotten her, since she was like a little puppy, like 3 months old. So she's older than my youngest sister, or than my younger sister. She's like the most perfect dog ever. If there was anything in our backyard, you know, she'd kill it. Squirrels, possums, rats, anything. She's killing it. Why am I showing you guys my dogs? Because without them, recording wouldn't be a challenge. These guys give me all the challenge I need for recording. Because when they're outside and you can hear them bark, the Blue Yeti picks it up and I don't like it. And whenever they're in here, when they're messing around and barking, you can hear it, and I have to make the most awkwardest editing cuts. So these guys are what make recording a challenge. So thank you. Without the challenge, what the fuck point would it be? So thank you guys, thank you. All right, so to the actual setup itself. This is pretty much in the small little messy-ish type areas where I do all my videos at. Basically, this right here is the only monitor I ever use. I don't have a dual monitor set up. Why? Because, you know, money, it's an issue type thing, you know. But once I get the funds that I need, you know, from work and everything, then you guys can, I can guarantee you guys like a dual monitor setup with an actual gaming monitor with like 1 millisecond response time and everything. This right here is just a gateway monitor. It's basically what I've been using for the past 7 years-ish. It holds up to like 1080p and stuff, so that's the only thing I care about. But I know I do need to upgrade a gaming monitor soon. This right here be the Logitech C920. I haven't been using it as often, but whenever I'm like just kind of lazy and want something to record on my computer for my face cam, I use this. It's a great webcam, probably the greatest webcam around. If they can upgrade to like some sort of a 1080p 60 frame per second webcam, I would totally get it. But that's the reason why I upgraded the camera I'm using now to make this whole setup video, which is a Sony HDR or PVR, something like that. God, I forgot the actual like numbers to it. I'll leave it in the description below. Only reason I got this camera is because it was like $100 off at my job, and I got an extra 10% off of it. In case you guys don't know, I work for Target, amazing company to work for. I fucking love my job. But yeah, there's that. This headset that I use isn't a gaming headset by any means. It's just a Skullcandy Hesh 2 headset with like the blue like jean texture to it, which is, I love it. Great sound quality. I can't wait to upgrade to an actual headset soon. If we go in here though, this little door right here, sorry, I kind of got messy right here. Forgot to use the tissue. Anyways, headset, if I were to use a gaming headset, this would be it, PX21. Great, I think it's like the best sounding mic out of any gaming headset out there. So yeah, definitely check the PX21 out. Who knows, maybe I might do a review on it. one of these days. I haven't done a review video in quite a while. Like, that's probably the most viewed video on my channel is that Dream Gear headset that I reviewed not too, like about a year ago. All right, now what I like to call the piece de resistance of the whole setup video is this Blue Yeti. Oh my God, I freaking love this Blue Yeti. This thing is amazing. Best USB mic out there that I know of. This thing is just absolutely ridiculous. Crazy good price for the price. Yep, I got it on Amazon. It's the Blue Yeti. There's not a lot to be said about the Blue Yeti that already hasn't been said in a lot of other videos. So yeah, Blue Yeti for my mic. Wintech pop filter. Windscreen, I think, is what it is. You know, it's great sounding windscreen. Whenever I'm using it, you can't even tell that the AC is on in my house. And then some random, you know, cheap generic pop filter that I got with the bundle. This thing works great. I haven't had any complaints with it so far. For $7, you can't go wrong with the pop filter. So, I mean, you know, it is what it is. Gaming mouse I use a Razer Naga. This thing is absolutely beautiful. I like to play Star Wars The Old Republic a lot. So, you know, these little number pads right here, or this number pad right here, is absolutely perfect. I absolutely love using it. I always macro certain things to the mouse. It's my favorite mouse out there. Got some G Fuel right there. I wanted to get pumped before the video, and you know what? That did the trick. Blood orange is like the best flavor out there for G Fuel. Make sure to check out G Fuel out at Gamma Labs. They make amazing shit, so definitely check that out right there. And then this is just a mini tripod. It's not, you know, nothing. It's nothing. I'm trying to make words, guys. I'm trying to make words that form a sentence. And this right here is a tripod, a mini tripod. You know, I paid like $20 for it. It works great. That's all I can say about it. It's a mini tripod. Right here is a wired mess in the back. Just ignore that. Completely ignore that. This right here is a Netgear, I want to say AC1200 wireless adapter. This thing is absolutely beautiful. I get more Wi-Fi than we actually pay for using this. So I absolutely love this thing. It makes uploads so much easier. I can upload like a 40-minute video in like less than 10 minutes. So this thing is absolutely beautiful. Without it, I don't know where I'd be. And the hand-me-down PC for my old grandpa. Thank you so much, grandpa. I really appreciate this computer. Without it, I would not be able to make this whole YouTube thing possible. And I tried to tweak it just a tiny bit, and granted, that wasn't really all that successful, but it's like a ZT case, you know, just a generic computer brand case. Inside has an 850 power supply, or an 850 watt power supply, which is probably why it's not doing so well right now, because I put it in and maybe it's just too much for the wall right over there, or it's just too much for my system. I know the problem isn't that it's too small, because the graphics card that's inside is only a GT 630, which doesn't really do a lot as far as gaming goes. So I know I need to update the graphics card, which I actually did. You guys can see right here, this Asus GTX 970 Mini. This thing is absolutely beautiful for what I did get to use it. It did everything I needed to do. Ran all my games in 60 frames per second. This right here is amazing. There's not much to be said about it. I mean, it's a GTX 970, one of the greatest graphics cards at its price range out there. It just it kept on freezing my system, and even my system now keeps freezing with the GT 630 I have in there. So, you know, I'll have to figure out what's wrong with it. One of these days, though, I will get you guys the content you deserve, not just some random 720p at, you know, I'd rather much have this graphics card than the one I have in there. Anyways, guys, within the world's smallest desk is just some random stuff. I got a mouse in here, got some manuals, an already used Steam card, oh well, some empty Pokemon deck boxes. Who remembers this? Who remembers this? The Soul Game Shark. Huh. Wonder what that's doing in there. And then just some random manuals. I got the old PS3 manual right here. I love this thing. So I don't love this thing. This thing's a piece of shit. I'll read manuals. Alright, so we got three more drawers to look into. This is just a bunch of power supplies. No one really gives a shit about those. Let's see what else is in here. Oh, we got some old controllers, you know, just some random things. N64 controller. Let's see, looks like I got a GameCube controller in there. A lot of PlayStation controllers. Oh, hey, look. Deep in the bottom of this is a Super Nintendo controller, and right next to it, it's best friend. JK, these guys hate each other. The Sega Genesis controller, six-button controller. That's, you know what? That's fucking awesome. That gives me motivation to see what's in the bottom drawer. And in the bottom drawer, it doesn't look anything as good. Oh, wait, no. But what is this? More Sega Genesis controllers, the older one with the whole, you know, three-button thing. And then, fucking Atari 2600 controller. Who the hell has those anymore? No, I'm just kidding, guys. I used to be a big old game collector. Alright, so yeah, guys, that was my setup video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I know it was a little bit longer than a lot of other people's. That seems to be a running trend with this channel, is that certain videos that shouldn't take that long, I start rambling off about other things, and that's what makes the videos longer than they should be. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video now. But before I go, I wanna show you guys my new outro video that Ross Thompson made me. I'll put a link in the description below for his channel. He makes awesome outros, outro templates and stuff like that. So definitely go ahead and check out his channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Sup guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to go ahead and click that like button down below for me, please, because I'd really appreciate that. Also, if you want to express your opinions about the video, make sure to do so in the comments section below, for that it's what it's there for. Also guys, make sure to follow me on all my social media, all the links will be down in the description below. Last but not least guys, if you want to go infinity and beyond the Call of Duty, make sure you also go ahead and click that red subscribe button for me, please, if you want to see all my content when it comes out on time. Again, thank you so much for watching, this has been Zappadap, I'm out. Peace.